How to use basic architecture to organize and comprehend vast amounts of information. Often you might find yourself in a position where you have to consume and understand vast amounts of information. Maybe it's a new job, a new role within your company, or a new assignment. Your first task is to quickly understand your environment so you can operate well within it. How do you do that? With information coming from many sources, you will create a mental model and build your perspective of the environment. This information comes to you in many ways. People might share information, documents that you read, presentations you attend, videos you watch, and your own Google searches, and so on. Combine this with your own experiences, your education, your perspective, your biases, and so on, and you end up with a complex mental model. A lot of detail in these sources can also vary. It could be from high level to granular. The trustworthiness of the information is also something to consider. For example, a document may be outdated compared to what you hear from a colleague. Your goal is to organize all this information gradually as you build and refine your mental model. You should understand the big picture, but also be able to dive into the details of specific areas when you need to. The mental model you create in this process is what you use to understand the world. Most people create this mental model subconsciously. Our schools didn't teach us how to create effective mental models, so each of us ended up creating our own versions. When the mental model gets too complicated or complex, it's difficult to hold it all on our heads. Over time, we also tend to forget some parts of it and confuse the other parts. What if there was a deliberate way to create these mental models? Then the task becomes easier, it brings clarity, and it becomes easy to communicate, which ultimately helps to drive organizational change. One excellent way to do this is through visuals. More than 60% of us are visual learners, and yet we hardly use the most powerful tool we have at our disposal. So let's get down into the details. I'll share an example scenario. Both of us will draw the picture together, but your picture will look different from mine. That's okay, because it depicts your version of the world. First, here's a scenario. You're going to take a break from your daily grind and go on a vacation for 3 days to some unique and exotic place. Get a sheet of paper and a pen. Draw a visual of this following statement. A map of your country and the location of your town in it. You can write out the name of the town as well. You will be using text to enhance understanding, and that's even better. Now pause the video here. Hit the play button only after you've drawn this picture. Here's my version of the picture. Now let's go to the next step. Choose a place you would like to go for a vacation and draw out how you would get there, including any stops, things you might see along the way, your mode of transportation, etc. Pause this video here and hit the play button after you have drawn your picture. Next, at your destination, how are you going to spend your days? Specifically, draw out what you're going to do for day one. Pause the video here and hit the play button after you have finished. Oh, and I forgot. Information in real life does not come in neatly packaged sequences either. Who's going to come with you on this vacation? Draw a stick figure of them. Your partner, your kids, your friends. Pause the video here and hit the play button after you have finished. I drew up my family. Now, let's get back to how you're going to spend days 2 and 3. Pause the video here and hit the play button after you have finished. There you have it. You've visually depicted your vacation. Don't worry that it doesn't look great. As long as you understand it, you're good. You can continue to refine this picture, or if it gets too crowded, you might choose another visual, but you know how these two visuals are now related or connected. In my case, I wanted to take a biking trip, but I'll do that on a separate sheet of paper, drawing out the map. And yet, I know how these two pictures are connected. Your set of visuals is similarly interlinked because they all connect under the same umbrella and concept of vacation. In the context of your whole life, This vacation is one experience at a particular point in time. So you see how this becomes a detail in the larger context of your life. In that part, you might show your workplace, what your partner does, and what your kids do. Perhaps one goes to a local school, another has a job as an engineer in a car company, and the middle one, well, don't ask. And so on and on. The visual model simply is a representation of reality. The level of detail that you attach and you put in is up to you on what you want to call out and what you don't want to call out. Now take the picture you've drawn and share it with your family to convince them to make this vacation a reality. Let's think about a different problem, back to the reality of work. Cloud migration is one major challenge for business transformation. How can we think about this? Perhaps you want to consider many clouds, so you're vendor independent, and you want to leverage the best of breed from each. You want to migrate only some of your data first to the cloud. What about the apps that use that data? They have to go too. You want to share data between clouds. This could get expensive because putting data in is not so expensive, but taking data out is. You want to rewrite or refactor some of your applications as you modernize them. You want to use the cloud features of scalability and availability, but you're concerned about security. You want to work with data from partner organizations, some of which are in the cloud and some not. And so on and on. What does your representation of your cloud migration strategy look like? Start with visualizing it to have deep conversations with leaders, so collectively you have better clarity and can make better decisions. In these exercises, you have used architecture to visually understand your ecosystem so you can make informed decisions on it. Your vacation drawing is architecture. If you enjoyed watching this video, please consider subscribing. For a one-page visual summary of this video, please sign up on my website. Thank you deeply for giving me the motivation to do what I do.